the siren went off, and we come down and check to see why the siren was blowing. The monitors never tripped. And when we come in, the fire building was already fully involved. There was no way of getting in and saving anything.
Some of the neighbors said they heard what they thought was an explosion, and the cause of fire is now suspected to be electrical in nature. Officials say the fire started here in the utility room and then spread up the back, across the roof, and finally, all the way to the front.
We're just trying to inventory the building right now to find out exactly what we lost and what we can salvage out of it, which it appears going to be very little.
Destroyed were the small community's fire hall, ambulance, rescue vehicle, and frontline pumper truck. An estimated total of nearly $1 million in damages.
It's more than just the fire department, you know. I've been in 22 years. It's, you know, hard to explain. It's kind of like a big family. But we'll do it over again. It's tough. You never expect it to happen. Fire departments aren't supposed to burn down. But this shows it can happen to anybody.
It's not certain when the station will be up and running, but until then, a host of other departments, including Hightown, Spartansburg, and Bloomfield, among others, will be on call for the duration. Anita Vogel, Jet TV Action News.
Another search by fire investigators, this time in Elyria, Ohio. Environmental and explosives experts spent today at the Aztec Catalyst Plant, where a series